Hope in the past three videos we have discussed about the basic working principle of diesel engine and components in the diesel generator set, and also we have explained what are all the important factors you need to consider while going for the selection of diesel engine as well as diesel generator set. So we have explained so many factors. So now here there is an example to understand the few factors and how we can select the generator sizing. So all those things you can understand here. As I already read the question, a power supply company has to install a diesel electric power plant at a hill station having an altitude of 900 meters above the sea level, and 4 units are planned, 2 or 500 kilowatt and 2 or 300 kilowatt are chosen to suit the load curve. So their load requirement is in such a way that load curve is nothing but in each and every half an hour what is your demand requirement. For example, in the first half an hour in your house, if you are operating two tube lights means 80 watts, and the second half an hour suppose you are operating a single tube light means the demand is 40 watts, and similarly when you combine all your loads on each and every half an hour period, what is your load changes, and that is desired as load curve. That will be considered as load curve, right? The engine used are 4-stroke 375 rpm engines, airless injection type is nothing but there is no supercharging. This terminology indicates that there is no supercharging. The maximum demand on the station is to be 1400 kilowatt at 0.8 power factor lagging. Maximum demand on the diesel engine power plant is nothing but 1400 kilowatt at 0.8 power factor lagging. The average load factor will be considered as 50%, an annual capacity factor considered as 44%. The generator efficiency may be taken as 93%. So here the efficiency don't confuse with diesel engine efficiency. Diesel engine efficiency in the order of 43 to 46%, whereas this generator is nothing but an electrical device. Input energy is a mechanical input energy, output is an electrical energy. That machine will give the efficiency around 93%, right? So you need to find out the three things: find the rating of a diesel engines, find the energy produced per year, find the annual fuel consumption, right? So find the ratings of the diesel engine. First thing is engine capacity to drive the 500 kilowatt. So why there is a 500 kilowatt? Already the question specifies we are going to operate 2 500 kilowatt and 2 300 kilowatt alternators, right? And capacities. So to meet out the their limit. So in such case, to operate a 500 kilowatt engine, what is a diesel engine required? So that means output of the generator you require 500 kilowatt. So what is the input energy required for the generator is nothing but 540 kilowatt. Output divided by efficiency will give the input. Similarly, for the another machine, that is 300 kilowatt machine alternator, this much required. Now while consider the altitude of the diesel engine, altitude factor of the, it is derating correction factor. Suppose your 100 kilowatt machine, when it is located in the higher altitude, that capacity reduction will happen, and that is given in the curve, right? So in this case, we are going to operate at the 900 meters above the sea level. In such case, your derating correction factor is 94%. That means, suppose your generator is 540 kilowatt, means only 94% of 540 alone you can get as an output. So when your diesel engine is not supercharged, that is also given, and this is the curve which gives the elevation on the feet mean sea level, above from the mean sea level. In your case, you are around 900 meters above the mean sea level. In such case, your efficiency is around 94%, right? So when you incorporate this, your first machine requirement is, diesel engine requirement is 575 kilowatt, and second machine similarly requires 346 kilowatt. Now you can calculate what is the energy produced per year. So maximum demand into load factor into total hours in a year is nothing but energy produced in such a way. The calculation gives 6.132 into 10^6 kilowatt hour. This is in the kilowatt hour energy, right? And what is the final, find the annual fuel consumption to produce this much amount of electricity units, or how much fuel consumption required. For that, there is another characteristics curve of the TG set DC generator system, and this x-axis is nothing but percentage capacity factor, and y-axis is nothing but kilowatt hour per kg of fuel. 1 kg of fuel will produce how much amount of units. So based on that, and already they, in the problem, they specify that plant capacity factor is around 44% or something, 44%. So the corresponding around 44%, what is the corresponding kilowatt hour produced per kg of oil is nothing but around, and I can see around 44%, you can see it is nothing but 2.3 or 2.4. So now this is the 2.3 kilowatt hour you can generate in a kg fuel. So to generate this much amount of kilowatt hour divided by 2.3 will give this much amount of kg fuel required in per hour. Kg per hour, 2.66 into 10^6 kg per hour required. So this is what the calculations, right? So hopefully this you can finalize your TG generator set. In the next class, we will discuss about the maximum demand meters and automatic power factor correction equipments and other occupancy sensors. All those things we will discuss in the next class. That is a separate CO. And thanks for watching. Thank you.